With 2021 coming to a close, I figured it is time to do a market update video. Now, typically I find these videos to be really dry and boring. So in this video, I'm gonna at least try to make it a little entertaining. Stick around. Hey guys, my name is Trent and I'm a realtor here in Idaho. If this is your first time to the channel and you're interested in learning what it's like to live, eat, sleep, work, play, and buy real estate here in Idaho, then this is the channel for you. Go ahead and tap that subscribe button, hit the notification bell so every time I come out with a new video, you get updated. And guys, I'm serious when I say this, every single day. I thought the market was gonna be slowing down, but every single day I am getting calls from people just like you that are serious about moving to Idaho and they need to have specific questions answered before they can decide if they really wanna move here or just how to do it. So if this is you, I absolutely love taking those calls and having those conversations. So if this is you, give me a call, shoot me a text, or write me an email. I will respond. I absolutely love helping people get moved here because this is a wonderful place to live. Now, let's get started. In this video, I am going to be focusing specifically on Kootenai County. But before we dive into that, what does Kootenai County consist of? Well, let's jump over to here. So Kootenai County is made up of several towns. Down here, you have Post Falls, which goes all the way up against state line. Up above it, you have the town of Hauser, which is next to Hauser Lake. You head northeast, you have Rathdrum. Head over further east, this is the Hayden area, which is next to Hayden Lake. Come down, you have Dalton Gardens, Coeur d'Alene. You come up here, and you have Athol. Now, there are other smaller towns that are included, like Garwood and Chilco, but I'm gonna discuss the major areas today. So, in Kootenai County, in 2018, the median home price was $250,000. At the end of September of 2021, the median home price is now $453,000. Now, I'm no math magician, but according to my calculations, that's about a 20% increase every single year over year for the last 4 years. Now, I get asked every single day, Trent, do you think that we are at the top of the market? Do you think prices are gonna start coming down? Now, I don't have a crystal ball. I can't predict the future, but there's several factors that I see that tell me this is not gonna slow down and it's only gonna continue, at least for the foreseeable future. The first one being that remote work is now becoming a total standard thing for most high-paying jobs. That was always the thing that kept people out of North Idaho, was that there wasn't a lot of opportunity to make good money. So even though it was really cheap to live here, there wasn't a lot of high-paying jobs to even be able to afford some of the nicer homes in the area. With remote work, you have good paying jobs that allow people to live and work wherever they want as long as they have good internet. And we do have good internet up here. So I think that's a really strong factor to why we're still seeing the continued growth. The other major factor has to do with some of the politics that we're experiencing in our country. Never before have we seen things so polarized, and as long as those factors are still in place, I think that is going to continue to drive people to move to more conservative states. As far as I can tell, those factors are not letting up. If anything, they're getting a little bit stronger, and so as long as that's still in play and we still have 36 plus months of this current administration, I think we're gonna continue to see people move in here. Another factor that I found today was an article that was on Deseret News. Looks like the information came from Zillow about the most overpriced markets in the country. And surprisingly, Boise is number one for being overpriced. They think that there's an 80% premium on the standard housing prices. In sixth place was Spokane, which is right next door to us, but what wasn't on that list was any town within Kootenai County. So even though we have seen an 80% jump over the last 4 years, market experts believe that it is positive growth, that it's real growth, that this isn't inflation, that these are real factors that are coming in and it's probably gonna be continued growth. Now, again, I don't have a crystal ball. I cannot tell you guys for sure that, yep, absolutely nothing's gonna happen. As you know, over the last couple years, it's hard to predict what's gonna be happening. We're seeing things that we thought would never happen, but they are. So But with all these factors, I made the decision myself in August to buy a house, and I had to consider this too. Is this gonna be another 2008 situation, or is this different? I believe 2008, what drove a lot of that was greed, people thinking I'm gonna buy this and I can sell it and make lots of money. We have a lot of other factors, and a lot of these factors I don't think are gonna be going away anytime soon. So I believe that the housing prices is going to continue to go up. All right, now that we got through the dry information, let's go down onto the ground and actually look at what this means for each individual town in Kootenai County. Now, the first one we're gonna look at is Post Falls. Now, I'm from Post Falls. I lived in Post Falls throughout my childhood. Love Post Falls. Post Falls is going to have the most opportunity for growth. There's a lot of corporations that are bringing some operations into Post Falls. There's a lot of developments, and they have the most area to expand. Now, the median home price in Post Falls is $425,000, and currently they have 72 homes on the market. Now, when I say median, what that means is your average home. This is gonna be about a 3-bedroom, 2-bath on a 1/6 of an acre with anywhere from 12 to 1,500 square feet. That's typically gonna be your average home in Kootenai County. Next, we're jumping into Hauser. Hauser is just above Post Falls, and a lot of the homes are out around the lake, which is going to bring the median home price a little bit higher than normal. Median home price out there is $680,000, and currently there are 3 homes on the market. Next, we're going up to beautiful Rathdrum. Rathdrum is also an area that is expanding, lots of new homes and growth happening up there. There are currently 37 homes on the market, and the average home price of $434,000. Next, we're jumping over into beautiful Coeur d'Alene, which right now, honestly, it is the most beautiful time of the year. Fall is absolutely gorgeous. The trees almost look like they're on fire. It goes from green to yellow to red, and then you still have the pine trees, which are green, and it's just beautiful. So if you do plan to visit, try to get here pretty quickly because the leaves are gonna fall and it's not gonna be as beautiful. Now, right now in Coeur d'Alene, you have 117 homes on the market with an average median home price of $515,000. Now, there are waterfront homes in Coeur d'Alene, and throughout Kootenai County, for waterfront, the average home price on the water is gonna be $1,150,000 for anyone who is interested in buying a home on the lake. Next, we're jumping up to Dalton Gardens, which is just north of Coeur d'Alene. Now, Dalton Gardens really is kind of a bedroom community. That's where a lot of houses are, not a lot of business, no downtown. And a lot of the homes, the median home price is going to be higher because a lot of the homes are on about 1 acre to 5 acres. This is an area where if you're not in a new development, you don't really have a lot of HOA rules or anything. So you can have cows, you can have horses, you can have chickens, you can have a garden. It's really awesome for people who are wanting that lifestyle. But the median home price up there right now is $742,000 with only 4 homes on the market. Next, we're going up to Hayden, which is north of Coeur d'Alene and Dalton Gardens. Now, Hayden, the home price is going to be a little bit higher because you have beautiful golf courses up there. You have Hayden Lake, and it's a highly desired area because you can choose. You can have your HOA developments, which are newer. You can have your custom home on 1 acre or more, or you can just buy your lot of land. They're still expanding up there. There's still growth. So the median home price is going to be higher. Right now in Hayden, the median home price is $529,000 with only 53 homes available. And lastly, we have Athol, Idaho. Now, this is a funny sounding name for a town, but it actually is a very highly desired area. This has some of the highest potential out of all of Kootenai County. I can't say too much. They have Silverwood Park up there, and I recently heard today that it was acquired by a major corporation. But more on that later in a later video once the news is official. Up there, this is a lot of rural living. You have Farragut State Park, which is right in there with Athol, next to Bayview, which is at the southern tip of Ponderay Lake. And median home prices up there are $540,000 with only 18 homes on the market currently. Now, I wanna hear from you. Do you guys think that Kootenai County is totally overpriced and inflated and it's destined to come down? If so, why? What are the factors that I'm not considering or I'm not seeing that might make you think that? But if you think that, no, I think the housing price is accurate and it's going to continue to go up because it is a highly desired area, and maybe there's factors that I didn't mention that are making you think that as well, I want to hear about that in the comments. I read all the comments. I respond to as many as I can. And as always, guys, if you are serious about moving here and you need help getting answers to your questions about what it's like, how to get moved there, what you need to prepare for, just reach out with a phone call, email, or text, day, nights, weekends. It does not matter. I love helping you guys get set up in this wonderful place in the United States of America. And until the next video, guys, I will see you later.